In this problem, we have two gliders are gliding towards each other, with glider A moving at 2 meters per second and glider B moving at 2 meters per second. Glider A has a mass of 0.5 kilograms and glider B has a mass of 0.3 kilograms. So if we have the initial momentum, right, it'll be mass times velocity plus mass times velocity, right, of glider A and glider B. So let's just plug in information. So for the mass of glider A, that was 0.5, right? And the velocity of glider A is 2. And so since these are coming at different directions, we'll arbitrarily say that right is positive. So for mass B, right? So if this is A and this is B, B would be negative, right? So the mass of B would be 3 and the velocity would be negative because it's coming in from the right. So this is negative. And so if you solve this, it'll become 0.4. So the initial momentum is 0.4. And the initial momentum has to equal the final momentum. And that'll come in handy later. So now we'll do is for the final momentum, it's equal to the same equation, right? Except the velocities are the final velocities, right? And so we'll plug in what we know, and we know the masses, so 0.5 and 0.3. Now what we can do is we know that the final velocity, right, of the gliders is, when you subtract them, are equal to the negative of the initial velocities when you subtract them. So for this part, right, we know this part. So negative, right, negative, the velocity of B is negative 2 minus the velocity of A is a positive 2. So this will be negative 2 minus 2 is negative 4, and then negative times negative is positive 4 meters per second. So what we can do with this is the final velocity minus the final velocity of A, final velocity of B minus final velocity of A is equal to 4, right? Because this entire thing became 4 when we solve for it. So we can rearrange that to say the final velocity of glider B is equal to 4 plus the final velocity of glider A. So now we can solve for the final momentum, right? Because the final momentum has to equal the initial momentum. And initial momentum we got was 0.4 right here. Initial momentum is 0.4. So we can plug in 0.4 and we know the masses of A and mass of B. So the other thing we did was we solved for the final velocity of B, right? We have this equation. So now using the final momentum, right, we can plug in for VBF right here. We can plug in this equation, 4 plus V, the velocity of glider A, the final velocity. So now since we have this equation, this is just algebra. You solve for VA, the final velocity of glider A, and you get negative 1 meters per second. And then using that knowledge, you can solve for glider B, the final velocity, and you'll get 3 meters per second. So I hope that helped, and thanks for watching.